Simpson Bowles.
Yeah.
Neither you nor the president at the beginning were supportive of it. First, you.
Well, Simpson Bowles is a very good, I think.
You say that now, but you did not say that at the time. You had real problems with it at the time.
Well, my problem with it is what it did as far as Social Security is concerned. But apart from that, we said it gave us a great deal to work with. It had good bones, so to speak. It was a good framework in terms of revenue, in terms of cuts, and in terms of defense spending and the rest. It was very bold.
Should Simpson Bowles be at the core of legislation to deal with the future of U.S. debt?
Well, it is an outside, you know, in other words, that it was developed on the outside of Congress. Congress has to work.
But it had Republicans and Democrats on the commission.
I know, but the Republicans.
Including the chairman of the House Budget Committee.
Yes.
Would Simpson Bowles have had a better chance if the president and you had been flat out supportive of it when it was announced by Erskine Bowles and Alan Simpson?
I think what the president did was correct, was to use Simpson Bowles as an outline, a framework about how we go forward. That was its appropriateness. It is, I had promised that if that committee had voted it out with 14 votes, whatever the vote was, that I would bring it up. Remember, we were still in the majority then, that I would bring it up on the floor. The committee did not vote it out. It may be how they built their consensus that they didn't have buy-in from enough people. That's part of how you get the vote, is everybody, you know, people buy into it. They understand why that consensus is necessary. I don't know why they didn't get the vote, but I had promised, and I said I will keep that promise. I will bring it to the floor. The Republicans said they were bringing it to the Republicans and Democrats. It was bipartisan last week, but it was more of a caricature of Simpson Bowles, and that's why it didn't pass. If it were actually Simpson Bowles, I would have voted for it.
When Americans in overwhelming numbers show that they don't approve of the Congress,
right.
Why do you think that is?
Well, they don't see, I don't approve of the Congress, so count me among them.
All right.
the fact is that we've had a period of time where there's been just obstruction to anything that the president wants to do. The public isn't aware of process.
But the first 2 years of this presidency had an overwhelming majority in the House and the Senate.
And we had,
until the Brown election in Massachusetts.
We had 40% approval for the Congress. It's about 25% of where it was. I didn't think 40 was good enough, but nonetheless, it's much lower now. Congress has always, let's put this in perspective. Congress has always been a mockery since the beginning of our country. And if you look at the history of it, they've always been fighting over one thing or another. When Speaker Polk, one of the only speakers, I think, to become president of the United States, he said, this place is so out of order that I'm not going to recognize anybody. Yeah. But the fact is that if you can get civility back, and that's why the public has to be part of this solution. They have to demand and insist on the civility, because it's a tactic by obstructionists. If you want to obstruct, you make it so unpleasant that no one wants to pay
attention.
What do you think? Join us online at charlierose.com.